Hi, I'm Cranny, and today we'll be talking about Germanic numbers, their origins, their evolutions, and yes, why a 10-year-old is technically a teenager. We'll start with the numbers 1 to 9. Every number just comes from its word in Proto-Germanic, with some interesting changes. Almost none of the languages keep the th in threes, only English and Icelandic. Because of the Ingveanic nasal spiritan law, the nasal in fimf was lost with languages like English, West Frisian, and Dutch, while German and Swedish kept it. However, small changes like these make no real difference. That was fairly simple, but now let's look at the numbers 10 to 19. What you notice is that in each language, there is a clear similarity not only between the numbers, but also the numbers of 1 to 9 as well. 11 and 12 derive from 1 and 2 with the leaf suffix in Proto-Germanic. The numbers 13 to 19 derive from 3 to 9, but with this teen suffix. 3 plus teen equals 13, 9 plus teen equals 19. Same in German, for example, 3 plus 10 equals 13, 9 plus 10 equals 19. And this is all from Proto-Germanic, so 3 plus tehun equals 3 tehun, neun plus tehun equals neun tehun. What's really interesting is where this teen suffix comes from. In English it may not be so obvious, but in a language like German or Dutch it is. The suffix just comes from 10. Because of some irregularity with how the word came to be, it is slightly different in English. Now, you might be beginning to make some connections. The word teenager just comes from teenage plus er, a suffix attached to show that it is a person, and teenage just comes from teen plus age, and teen just comes from that teen suffix, which is just 10. So, why would someone who is 10 not be a teenager? Yes, I know that this is a stupid etymological technicality, but still. Anyways, to finish it off, let's look at the tens. Everything is fairly simple here too, just the base numbers with different suffixes. There are some irregularities, however. The word 20 in Proto-Germanic was most likely twi tihuis, but the form that would have evolved in the most modern words was twine tihuis. The words for 70, 80, and 90 in Proto-Germanic also had a different suffix that in most forms in most languages was replaced by the normal suffix, with the exception of tachtig in West Frisian and tachtig in Dutch. From what I know, the suffix did some shuffling around and ended up placing a T at the beginning. However, I'm not exactly sure about that. Anyways, thanks for watching. Feel free to subscribe.